Hi, I'm Justin Bender, Portfolio Manager at PWL Capital in Toronto, and this is episode 6 of my Do-It-Yourself Investing series. Today's lesson is on how to build an ETF portfolio at National Bank Direct Brokerage. For example, we'll be purchasing the 5 ETFs from my 40% fixed income, 60% equity model portfolio. Please feel free to download the model portfolios from my blog before getting started. After reviewing our account details, we find that there's $20,000 of cash available for investment within the Canadian dollar RSP account. We'll begin by hovering over the Transactions tab at the top of the screen and selecting Stocks from the menu. This will bring us to the Stocks Order screen. First, we'll ensure that we're trading within the correct account. This is the Canadian dollar RSP in our example. Next, we'll ensure that the Operation drop-down menu is set to Buy. We'll skip over the Quantity field for now and enter VCN as our symbol. We'll also ensure that the market is set to Canadian and then click on the Quote button. This will populate a quote below the trade details. As we're buying an ETF, we'll be focusing on the ask price, which is the price per share that an investor is willing to sell the ETF to us for. To calculate the number of shares we need to purchase, we'll use our computer's calculator. Multiplying the total account value of $20,000 by VCN's target allocation at 20%, or 0.2, gives us $4,000. We then divide by the current ask price of the ETF, which is $30.07 in our example. This equals 133 shares. We can just round down to the nearest whole share. Let's go ahead and enter 133 in the quantity field. For the price, I prefer to select price limit, as it puts a cap on how much we're willing to pay for the ETF. In the price limit field, enter an amount that's a couple cents higher than the current ask price. Even if you use a higher limit price to place your trade, you'll still receive the lower ask price if it's available. By selecting day in the expiry field, your order will be canceled by the end of the trading day if it goes unfilled. You can ignore the restriction field. We can then click on Submit to review your trade. You'll notice a warning stating that the current commission is excluded from today's buying power. National Bank Direct Brokerage is currently offering commission-free Canadian ETF trades if your order is for at least 100 shares. We'll see later on in this tutorial that a number of our trades below this amount will be charged the standard $9.95 trading commission. Once you've had a chance to review the order details and verify that the transaction value is approximately the dollar amount that you'd like to purchase, accept the warning by selecting the checkbox and then click on Confirm. And to place your next trade, hover over the Transactions tab at the top of the screen and select Stocks from the menu. For the next trade, we'll ensure that the Canadian dollar RSP account and buy are selected. We'll then enter VUN as our symbol. We'll select Canadian as our market and then click on the Quote button. We'll multiply our total account value of $20,000 by 20% and divide this value by the current ask price of $41.42, which equals 96 shares. We can then enter 96 in the quantity field. We'll select price limit and enter a price that's a couple cents above the current ask price. We'll ensure that the expiry is set to day and then click on submit. As the number of shares that we're buying is below 100, a commission of $9.95 will apply for this trade. After verifying the trade details, we'll click on confirm. We can then hover over the Transactions tab at the top of the screen and select Stocks from the menu. For the next trade, we'll ensure that the Canadian dollar RSP account and buy are selected. We'll then enter XEF as our symbol. We'll select Canadian as our market and then click on the quote button. We'll multiply our total account value of $20,000 by 16% and divide this value by the current ask price of $26.17, which equals 122 shares. We can then enter 122 in the quantity field. We'll select price limit and enter a price that's a couple cents above the current ask price. We'll ensure that the expiry is set to day and then click on submit. After verifying the trade details, accept the warning by selecting the checkbox and then click on confirm. We can then hover over the Transactions tab at the top of the screen and select Stocks from the menu. For the next trade, we'll ensure that the Canadian dollar RSP account and buy are selected. We'll then enter XEC as our symbol. We'll select Canadian as our market and then click on the quote button. We'll multiply our total account value of $20,000 by 4% and divide this value by the current ask price of $22.29, which equals 35 shares. We can then enter 35 in the quantity field. We'll select price limit and enter a price that's a couple cents above the current ask price. We'll ensure that the expiry is set to day and then click on submit. As the number of shares that we're buying is below 100, a commission of $9.95 will apply for this trade. After verifying the trade details, we'll click on confirm. We can then hover over the Transactions tab at the top of the screen and select Stocks from the menu. For our final trade, we'll try to use up as much of the remaining cash as possible. we currently have $8,036.38 available. We'll once again ensure that the Canadian dollar RSP account and buy are selected, and then enter VAB as our symbol. We'll select Canadian as our market and then click on the quote button. We'll take our remaining cash balance of $8,036.38 and divide this value by the current ask price of $25.65, which equals 313 shares. We can then enter 313 in the quantity field. We'll select price limit, and this time we'll actually enter price that's the exact same as the current ask price. We want to try to use up as much of the remaining cash as possible while ensuring that we don't place the account into a debit position. We'll ensure that the expiry is set to day and then click on submit. And after verifying the trade details, we'll accept the warning by selecting the checkbox and then click on confirm. Now that the final trade's been placed, we can view the new portfolio holdings by hovering over the accounts tab at the top of the screen and then clicking on asset details. Here we'll find that we now have about $4,000 of our portfolio in Canadian stocks, $4,000 in US stocks, $3,200 in international stocks, $800 in emerging market stocks, and $8,000 in Canadian bonds. If you have any questions, please feel free to send them to me via email, jbender@pwlcapital.com.